Q&A. If you're viewing this video, this channel, not my name, is Unroy or Renee. I am going to be doing questions that I came up with. I've done one of these in a previous video. I'll put it in the description as well as in like the cards on this side. This is going to be a Q&A. If you have clicked on this video, then welcome to my YouTube channel. I don't really get a lot of like views and on my YouTube. Like, I would like to grow my channel, but I also fear of having a big platform because I think of like meet and greets. I know there's this one YouTuber that I watch. She doesn't really like go out to when YouTubers go on brand trips and stuff, and she doesn't do meet and greets. I am the type of person, like, if you guys were wanting to ever meet me, I feel like that's so weird. Just know I would feel very awkward. It would be nice to grow my YouTube channel, but you know, I feel like it's very impossible to grow it because I was watching this one YouTuber, Tiffany Ferg. Her latest video was on like how YouTube was paying celebrities to put up YouTube content to keep advertising on their website app. Of course, it always comes down to money. One thing I don't like about myself is whenever I'm watching a certain person and I become obsessed with them, I will start to like talk like them and try to be acting in a way like them, like in my head though, and maybe around myself, not really around others, but it, like I would like it if I was just acting like Keisha, no one else, just myself. Because, you know, I don't want to get in the habit of doing that around people, and I just don't think I should be doing it at all, because I just need to be Keisha, you know? There's just certain people that I watch that, like, I feel like a freshness from. I have a son. He is 3 years old, and in March, he will be 4. Not ready. I need him to go back to 1, and I'm definitely not ready for him to be in school. I'm like scared. I'm so scared. And as for having more kids, I don't see that happening. Sometimes I just wish I was a little more smarter when it came to your future, I guess. I mean, I love my son to death, but sometimes I just wish I was smarter and I thought about like what I wanted to do in my future. So a lot of times I feel like doing certain things kind of, I just feel stuck in a way because I like need a babysitter or I just gotta work around other people's schedules. So, and I really, really don't want to wait another 18 years to go to New York and hopefully live there. Like, I really hope that I can see myself going to New York whenever my son is around, like, out of school and, you know, is living in his own place. I don't know if I can do it, though, to be honest, because I don't know if I want to be in a state where I know absolutely nobody, and I just like being around my family. So I feel like I would be, I think I might be lonely living in a different state where I know absolutely nobody. And I just feel like it would feel like a completely different world to me, because I know nobody, like I'm an alien or something. I am paranoid. People make me very paranoid, and I just don't think this world is great. I just think of like people who are inappropriate when it comes to children, and what I hear on the news. I think there was like something on the news about a teacher putting kids in like closet or something. I am like, that's what makes me scared for my son to go to public school. People, sometimes they're just in the head, I'm sorry. The scenery might be pretty, but the people, some people just make this world an ugly place. I doubt myself, like, at work a lot when I'm doing a certain part of my job that I absolutely hate. I just talk so badly about myself, and I doubt myself when it comes to doing new things that I don't know if I'll be good at, or if I feel like I'll f up, then I just will doubt myself. When I'm not at work, and if I'm not thinking about it, then I feel like okay, but I just sometimes end up thinking about it. Or thinking about starting something new, and then I'm like, oh, I'm not going to be consistent with this. I'm not going to be able to do this. Like, what if I mess it up? So that's like when I tell myself. I think I've been pretty consistent with my YouTube, which a long time ago I didn't think I would be, because I would be like a few months off of YouTube. I would post like one video, and then like 2 months would go by, and I wouldn't have another video up yet. So I have decided to, like, in my motion videos, I will not always look like black hair and like the normal clothes that I wear. Like this blazer, I don't wear this out in public. I am not very confident with my upper arms, let's just say that. I have a cardigan, but I just didn't think it would look as good with this color of blazer, even though I think it looks a little weird on me. This playlist is like just me going to be looking different in my motion videos, and then I also put like the after haul type of videos in this playlist, to where I'm hauling off the things that I want to do a haul on. I'm gonna try to do all the things that I've used or things that I really want to mention in the video, especially the look, like the outfit. And I'm hoping to film one with me wearing my pink wig. So yeah, that's like what the playlist is. I'm very excited for it because it's like me dressing up as someone else, someone different. I think the only thing that makes me unhappy about it is the location. I'm hoping to like think of like look on the Google to see like decor and like different seating, the wall decor or something for my action motionness. And I really want to do acting, so that's like the closest thing I came up with. Creating myself differently, because I don't know if I could actually do acting in real life. Well, I mean, I feel like I really couldn't, because I live in Texas. There's just not none of that going on. I am very much single. I honestly don't know if I want a romantic relationship. I don't think I want a full commitment relationship. I think I'm just wanting to have a good time, if you're catching my drift. I don't really want to go on any dating apps, because I've done that in my previous relationship, and I don't want to meet a stranger. I'm not, and especially with me being paranoid with people. And there was this thing that happened here in Alberta, where this girl's boyfriend came up to her job, and that's like something I think about, and it just, like, she passed away and he passed away, let's just put it that way. People are fucking crazy. I think New York is like a cozy state, but it's really cold too. I love the look of snow. I just feel like it looks cozy, and I feel like around Christmas time it would just be so beautiful. I used to have like a photo of a tree that I found on Google in the New York place. Oh, in Times Square, New York Times Square. I think it's so pretty. I have been wanting balayage hair for the longest time. I've ordered hair dye products and stuff to where I can do it on my own. Of course, I ordered this probably like in the beginning of 2018, and I just have not done it yet. I don't know if it expires. I would assume it does, though. I just don't think it would last like so long. I already kind of know my next color, which is burgundy red. I really am curious to know how I look with burgundy hair color. I'm just really wanting that color more than a balayage, but I also want to experience having balayage hair. I think it would be safer to do the balayage because there's like lighter colors there, and then move to the burgundy red, so I wouldn't have to like go burgundy first, and then once I wanted to try balayage hair, I wouldn't have to re-bleach it. I've only bleached my hair probably like once in my life, and I was trying to go purple, but I was too like into the orange brassiness. So yeah, I was like into that scene makeup too. I wouldn't say that I'm excited about starting my day. I need a car because, like I said, other people have work. You know, they go to work. Nothing's really changed. I'm able to drive myself places when the car is available. I think whenever I'm at work on the weekends, I start to want to, I think about like working out in the mornings, but like during the week, because I work weekends and I'm off during the week. I like to think of how I'm gonna do my week, but I don't do it because I'm not like excited or I'm not motivated enough. Especially when it comes to working out, I'm very lazy when it comes. I don't mind running because I feel like that's easy, but when it comes to doing push-ups and squats and lifting weights, I'm just so lazy. I don't want to do it. When I ran out of my pea drinks, and yesterday I went back to the dollar store to go get some more. They were out of stock, not there, nowhere to be found. Also, my job, because there's a certain part of my job that I absolutely hate, and I just talk so much shit to myself in that time. Once that part of the job is done, I then will start to like, I kind of talk crappy towards myself, but not as much. Also, social media. Yeah, I think I put Instagram in a different part of my phone so I wouldn't really get on it or see it. A lot of people that I follow on Instagram just have like a great life, and you know, it's mainly people who live in California, I guess. YouTubers. I think it just, I am on it a lot, and I feel like I can't really get anything that I want to do done, so I just thought I'd log out and put it in a different part of my phone. I I don't have any friends. I don't. Like, very bad at keeping in touch with people. Or if we never really spoke often before, I definitely am not one to reach out. Talk to a person if I feel like I just didn't really talk to them to begin with. I feel like there's certain things that happened in their life that makes me feel like I can't really talk to them. You know, like new relationships and stuff, obviously. Yeah, I'm not very good with making friends. I'm not great with keeping in touch with old friends. I'm just not very good at it. That's just me. That's my personality, I guess. I love an introverted girl who can also be outgoing if she had a fucking car. I have a set realistic number for my YouTube channel. I don't know if it's gonna happen because literally it takes forever to even get like known on YouTube or like get around for people to see your videos. I don't really think of myself as a YouTuber because I'm definitely not a YouTuber. I'm like less than what you could call a YouTuber. I do like making YouTube videos. And I don't know if I want to say this because I believe in jinxing, I think it's getting jinxed, but if I don't reach the goal, then it's whatever. But my goal is to have my 30 subscribers, people, supporters, on my YouTube channel. I am at 21 right now, so I need like 9 more to reach that goal. I was being realistic, okay? I was at 19 subscribers, or 18 or 19 for the longest time, so I'm just trying to be realistic. I don't really think I have, well, I don't really claim to have a religion. I just don't know if God exists. I don't like to, if he were to ever exist, I don't like to ignore his existence. I told somebody this a long time ago at work. They did not understand what I was saying. They were like, I don't know, saying something like, if you don't believe in him, you don't believe in him. And I was just, I don't know if his existence was, I don't know, I'm just not a real. I used to go to church when I was younger though. And then as you grow up, I just feel like you kind of are questioning it. So I feel like I just don't know. I do pray, like, I do pray to God if he exists. I don't like to think to ignore his existence. And I also like to pray to dog. I also like to pray to like my guardian angels who like passed away. I feel like they are definitely, I don't know, I just feel like your guardian angels are your family members that passed away, and that I feel like I've had a pretty decent, safe life when it comes to other people. And I don't know, this is so weird. I feel so awkward. I just feel like they can look over you and protect you, even though they're probably just spirits. I don't claim to have a religion though. Well, I finished all my questions. Of course, my camera cut out. No surprise there. But that was all the questions. I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I will see you in my next one. Bye. Do I always say bye with this hand? Bye.